No.
Hey, Bammers!
No. I better not. Somebody what? Somebody say the ranking order of these. I know I didn't get triangles.
I'm pretty sure Mandy outranks us all.
Yeah.
What?
Yeah.
No. Square, I guess that makes sense. It's weird. Triangles,
yeah.
Like,
hey, guys. Lost. How's it going? Happy Thursday. Woo woo.
Happy Thursday.
Oh, here we go.
No, it goes a long time.
Does it? Oh, yeah. That actually is longer than I expected. All right, there we go. All right, who do we got on today? Trisha, wow, can't wait to get some hints from Adam. Well, Trisha, you're going to have to get hints from me and Hannah instead.
No, don't. Or none. Or we'll take a break from
you. I actually want to give a few hints today.
Oh, are you thinking?
Yep, I got some
really?
Teasers on the way. Not too teased.
Teaser-ish.
I don't know.
Ooh.
But we'll be giving away, doing some stuff. We have some fun giveaways today. We've got Mandy over up in the top right corner.
I think we have some cool trailers.
Yeah.
Or did we?
Yeah. Oh, yeah. We got some great stuff for you guys today.
And a funny game.
Rachel Ann, hey, how's it going? Let's see. Who else is on? Jim Baxter loves teasers. I love teasers as well. Except, it's funny, certain movies I hate teasers for
know.
Because I want to absolutely know nothing
yeah.
going into the movie.
That's fine. That's normal. I was telling Mandy earlier, I'm so weird.
What?
I really will Google an episode of something or a movie and read everything that happens first and then watch it.
Like, wait, before you watched it?
Yeah.
why would you do
know.
That?
No, I don't want a surprise.
Why don't you just watch it?
I don't want any surprises. I need to know. I've been finishing
terrible.
Up The Last Kingdom, that Viking show.
Uh-huh.
And I'm like, sick of myself, but I always just Google who if anyone dies in this episode because I have to know because it's like Game of Thrones, like they'll often kill someone you like, so I'm like just
right
so that I don't be like what.
Oh, see, but that's the whole that's
I know I like it both.
I don't
I
how
like
can
it
you
both
do it that
ways.
Way I don't get that
I like it both.
I don't get that.
I'll watch it without the synopsis too, but for some reason I go don't look like, but I do no couch cam because
no couch cam because Adam isn't here. Adam is at a
Secret location.
Secret hotel this week. He's
Which
been
I didn't
where
even
he,
know that.
He's
I feel
been
bad. I've
he's
been
holed
him.
Up and working furiously on some really cool stuff that you guys will soon find out about.
That pertains to the 19th of May.
May 19th. We're going to talk about that in a bit. Let's see. Jonathan Salato, whatever happened to the other BAM guy? Well, he's at a hotel.
He's secret location.
That's
Sorry.
Right. And Mandy doesn't have a beanie on. Oh, there she goes.
That was even stranger than Adam not being here. I noticed that when I walked upstairs.
There's
I was like, what
beanie.
Are you thinking?
There we go. Now Adam, I saw him comment. Hi,
yeah,
Adam.
Really, he just said something.
Adam's probably going to be online for like 5 seconds, drop some snarky remark, and then leave.
And then bounce,
yep.
embarrass us, and then go.
Yep. The world is whole again. Mandy has a beanie on. There it is.
I feel comfortable again. Hey.
Oh, it's the lavender. Well, everyone put in the comments what color you think it is, because it's like that dress, you know, that they're
oh,
like,
yeah,
blue
yeah,
or
exactly.
gold or white. That's her hat.
it's
and I'm not
going to
say
actually.
What it is.
Depending on it, if you're male or female, you like.
Yeah,
you see.
And your age, where you were born.
All right, so we have some giveaways that we're going to be doing. We got some cool ones. We're
yeah,
gonna
really
be,
cool ones.
Yeah,
today.
We're gonna be giving away a free subscription box of your choice.
Of Anime Geek and Horror.
Mm-hmm. Okay. And we are gonna be giving away this guy right here, which is pretty cool. This is
Oh yeah, I love.
If you
this gal
for those of you who've seen Avengers Endgame, this
okay.
For those of you who've seen it,
tone.
Yeah. Hmm.
Watch all of it tonight. All
right, you got it, the whole thing.
Mm-hmm.
This Morgan was Tony Stark's daughter, and if you remember, there was like a whole scene where she was in a play. She was like in a little treehouse that she did, and then there was the one, "I Love You 3000." That mm-hmm. that whole thing. Anyway, the actress that played her, the little girl, her name's Lexi Rabe. And she's cool. She's only
adorable.
She's only like 9 years old right now.
Oh wow!
Now, like today.
Anyway,
so we had a signing with her a year or two ago.
Yeah.
And so she signed it. She signed it, Lexi. So.
And this is actually that girl is going places because she's.
Oh
a good
yeah,
actress.
She's
actually a good auto.
Yeah, that's
she's
fantastic.
Not done.
Yeah. So anyway, we're giving away one of these, Beckett Certed. And then the last thing we're going to be doing is giving away a David Nakayama comic, which I'm excited about.
Color Bleed.
Mm-hmm. We'll give you an example of that later. Mm-hmm, and okay. Yeah. So how do they win?
Well, you're going to comment, and yep. You're going to play our game with us. You'll see what it is.
Mm-hmm.
Say nice things to Mandy about her hat.
Yes, always.
She'll be selecting. And then I think totally at random, and if you say nice things, so not totally random, I guess, she'll pick three names at the end, bring it to us, we'll read them off, and then you will email in giveaway at the Bambox, giveaways at the Bambox.
Either one works.
Your choice, whichever one works. You prefer. It all goes to Mandy.
Laker J said they didn't know that they had a rescue pop. Yeah. So they don't have at least when we did the signing, they didn't have a pop for Morgan, the little girl, but they did have a pop for Tony Stark. Well, for mm-hmm.
Iron Man.
Gwyneth Paltrow's character.
Pepper Potts.
Pepper Potts. I'm thinking Penelope, but no. Yeah, Pepper yeah, Potts. Yeah, yeah. So, but she. So Pepper. Has her own little Iron Man suit, and or rescue suit, and mm-hmm. So it was signed on that.
Look,
so that's
Hannah,
pretty cool.
Did you watch Iron Man?
Yep.
Okay. Remember that's where I have been. Hannah.
No, I knew that from his breakdown.
Hannah has been. I sat down today and gave Hannah the 30-minute version of all the MCU movies and shows from like. 2008
when you
onwards.
Put it like that, it was talent,
and it was an hour long.
It might have been an hour long. Well, how do you explain all of that at once? So what? Hannah's seen bits and pieces, but not the whole
but
thing.
But now I
so.
Feel like I've seen the whole thing. Like I'm totally all caught up.
There it is.
I now can go on to watch Multiverse of Madness.
All right, yeah, we're excited about that.
Yeah,
so
yeah.
Sweet. Well, yeah, let's start kind of just giving you guys some updates.
Okay.
There's a lot going on here. I have been going crazy at the warehouse.
Yeah, but, I know. Every time I hit you up for something, you're like, hold on, at the warehouse?
Yeah, yeah,
what?
Exactly.
Did
wait,
you
wait.
Live? Do you move in there?
I feel like I should get a cot there or something. The
yeah, I know. That's not
the warehouse been working like crazy getting all the fire stuff, fire sale stuff. Let me tell you that like some people, you guys went crazy on this fire sale. Like some people, I swear their orders are like a full pallet worth of items.
Yeah,
it's insane. We've
it's
been
not
trying to.
Mind,
yeah, it's we're like the warehouse is scrambling trying to find boxes to fit all this stuff in and.
Oh, I see.
But,
like if you ordered a whole bunch.
Oh yeah, there's some people that order like dozens and dozens
yeah.
of boxes, and it's insane. So we're getting all that out. It's the fire sale starts shipping tomorrow. We're gonna then try and we'll get the rest out at the beginning of the next week. Some of it might be pushed a little later on into the middle of next week or so. But we're working on it. We're working like mm-hmm. crazy. But as I said, probably about three quarters of it will be going out tomorrow. So
oh, awesome.
So Trisha Wilde,
hey,
I ordered 16
awesome.
Boxes, not too many. Yeah, exactly.
Your those pallet will be in next
Trisha,
week.
You're part of the problem here.
What do you want all your stuff in?
Right. So yeah, no, it's cool though. There's a lot of great stuff. So we are so that and then we also have the Extinct and Demon Slayer boxes. So
ready to go.
They are just all the stuff is here except for one piece of them, which is still being delivered. So it's supposed to be in today, but it looks like it's got pushed to tomorrow.
What are you talking about? What?
I know. So that means that those boxes will probably be shipping on like Monday.
Okay.
So we'll get those out.
That's still fine.
The Slayer and Wrath boxes are we're hoping to get out. Next week, it might be the following week. It just depends
okay.
if everything comes in on time. And then next week, of course, we're getting all of our sub boxes out. So by the end of by next Friday. So
the warehouse loves us right now.
Oh well, I wouldn't put it that way, but they are they're working hard. They are working hard. No, they're excited to send your guys' stuff out.
Uh-huh.
It's fun because every time we do a fire sale. We start going through stuff and you know, there's always people like, oh gosh, like I forgot we did this or we had this. And so there's a lot of really cool stuff.
Mm-hmm. I know it's the best time of year, like going through like the vaults and the warehouse. Mm-hmm.
Exactly. So
there used to be a container, like a storage unit. Do we still?
We have
that?
Two.
And through it.
But yeah, so we need to figure out what's in there. I think mostly non-inventory, but I don't know. It may maybe there's stuff in there.
Adam
is a hoarder.
I know.
Adam's
instead of getting rid of something, he's like, get another unit, another storage unit.
I mean, there's a fine line between collector and hoarder, and I think there's a gray in there somewhere.
You're right. What if it's like something
he's a hoarder. He's a hoarder. That there's no fine line for him.
Ew.
Yeah. So, yeah. Tara R, I'm so excited for the Extinct Box. I have a feeling it's amazing. It will be.
It's amazing.
I absolutely love that box.
It's so good. Oh my god, it's so good.
I was creating the little insert for it today,
yeah.
And just going.
Oh yeah, I know
going,
you're asking.
So
that.
So
yay!
Cool. So very cool. Lots of awesome stuff. Okay.
Everything's coming straight to you in a second.
In a second. We are next. I wanted to talk about May 19th. Now that's still 4 weeks away, three, four weeks away.
No idea.
4 weeks, I believe, from today. It's a Thursday night, and it is going to be, it's our switchover for the start of the June box.
Mm-hmm.
And guys, you do not want to miss it. This is going to be absolutely epic.
If you've been to the ones in the past, you'll know
how
exciting and fun they are. They're hilarious, like inside jokes. You have to go. You won't know anything about Adam's short shorts.
Oh, no one wants to know that. Oh. But so May 19th, make sure. So we won't be having our live at the normal time. It'll be a few hours later. But let me tell you, we're going to be doing amazing giveaways during that time.
Crazy
giveaways. And you guys are going to get a glimpse.
Read something probably from Chris's wall and Adam's wall.
At least Adam's. At least Adam's.
Oh, nice. Cause he's
maybe I might share a thing or two. Anyway. Make sure you mark that off on your calendars. It's going to be May 19th, Thursday night, and you will get a glimpse to see what is coming, and there's a lot of very, very excited stuff coming.
Things are going to look a little different after that.
In a good way.
In a good way.
In a good way. Sweet. Adam and Chris are the best boss ever. Thank you, Chan Schuler.
You are not reading that.
Chan Schuler.
No, that's you even sounded like you were just making it up.
I can't even give an opinion.
Adam and Chris are the best boss ever.
Oh, that's awesome.
Give them a prize. No.
Now, but see, I don't pick the prizes, so. You know.
Oh, and Mandy doesn't. We'll see if she agrees or not.
They're pretty cool.
Waiting is hard. Sarah Cole Newport. Yes, waiting is hard. I have to say. Part of what's interesting here for us is that we have to plan a couple months out just to make sure everything's here, when it needs
some
to be.
Some things take way longer than others.
Right. So like we're working on our like July. We're starting the whole process for our July art and our July autographs and everything.
Mm-hmm.
So we already know what's happening in June and what's happening in May, and obviously we're shipping out April like right now.
Mm-hmm.
So we know what's coming, and it's so hard sometimes, especially when we know like some really amazing things that are happening, not to spill the beans. And that so waiting is hard in that.
Yeah.
I think waiting is almost harder when you know.
Oh, sure.
And you're excited.
Right. Well, so. Adam can't even be here anymore because he's like off thinking about it and planning about it. Like, how about he can't come to these until the 19th, because he's like explosive right now.
Oh, I know. Adam keeps contacting me on Slack. That's how we communicate when we're not together, and sending me stuff. And oh my gosh, guys, you guys are gonna flip. So, speaking of stuff that's coming up,
ooh.
I feel like we should at least give a few teasers. Hey.
For what? What do you mean?
Well, we have I have three boxes I want to tease today.
You do? Wait, that's not even.
I know.
We didn't discuss this.
I know.
Oh, well,
I know.
Nobody's here to stop you. I don't
here,
know.
Here, let's see. I got a here.
Oh yeah!
There we are.
Oh wow!
Yeah, get a little macho man.
Mm-hmm. So teasers?
Okay. Okay. Well,
Okay,
go ahead.
No, I was just going to say, no, stop. Stuff like that.
Yeah, that's fair. Well, here's the deal. I wanted to do one cool thing. So you guys are...
Russian Doll Season 2 is out.
I've not seen Russian Doll. Is it good?
It's not your type of thing, but it's
Is that
good.
Like a horror thing?
I wouldn't say horror, but it's strange.
It sounds strange.
Russian Doll. There it is.
You should watch it.
Okay, so one of the plus boxes the plus box that we have up right now, because we have a plus and an ultra that are live right now. Mm. Our plus box, I got to be careful that I don't give anything away. Like real.
Yeah.
Our plus box, one of the options so the theme is gothic, okay?
Mm-hmm.
And one of the options that you can do is you can get the photo,
yeah,
which is going to be great, because the photo is going to be really cool. But we are also offering the ability to do a get a signed item, and I think we actually announced it. It's a signed coffin. Now, we've never seen a signed
full
coffin.
Full size, no.
Yeah, not full size. But I did want to show you guys, as the teaser, I wanted to show you guys the coffin that we're getting signed that you guys can order right now. Here, you want to pull that out?
Here you go.
All right, check this bad boy out. Oh, nice.
I've been waiting all day for you to open that and see my Oreos. I'm so serious.
Food will not be included. Mm. But check out
unless
this
you want some
coffin.
Oreos, because we ordered too many.
Here, you hold it, because it's in my black shirt. You can't see it. Oop.
Oh, because the lid comes off, which makes it even more awesomer.
So that's super cool. So if you show the side of it, like it's just legit.
It can hold a lot of snacks.
So this is going to be a very unique piece for your guys's for your guys's collection. And the person signing it, you guys are going to flip over, and it's going to make so much sense.
So much fun.
But I have to say, we have never seen. I mean, we've seen a lot, because even before BAMBOX, we ran an auction where we did a lot of memorabilia, and we ran a store where we did a lot of memorabilia. In all of our time, we've never seen a signed coffin. This is a new one for us. So
yeah, if you go on eBay, how much can you get? It's like, I don't know.
Well, there aren't any.
Well, yeah, we're the first people putting it out.
So I don't know.
Imagine this on your little shelf with your other other collection.
Right.
So cool.
Anyway, I highly, highly recommend that you get one of these.
It's red felt on the inside.
We're also doing some that that are purple on the inside, and we'll probably do a limited edition of those. So
awesome.
So very excited. I also learned, as I was researching this, that the difference between a coffin and a casket.
Oh, a casket.
Oh, I was Googling.
Were you?
So is that what y'all been doing?
I'm sure probably all of you know this, but for those of you who may not, to win Jeopardy someday, a coffin a casket is straight, where a coffin has the angles.
That's not what I would have guessed.
Yeah, and so a casket also typically you can open it halfway, you know, to kind of see.
That's what I'm gonna do.
Where coffins you can't, but yeah, it's the bevel makes it the coffin versus a casket. So
I don't think people get buried in coffins anymore, do they?
I suppose it's just the shape.
Yeah, it's pretty much the shape. I don't know. I think they might. I think coffins are kind of a thing of the past in general. Yeah. But yeah.
Mandy, are you gonna have an open casket at your funeral?
It's funny that I know, right? I actually just talked about this.
I know, I bet.
We
that's why I'm wondering.
What are you doing?
Come up with?
I just want my cat with me. I don't know.
You just want your cat with
not,
me.
But
all right,
you
you're going full
with
Egyptian.
Your oh,
you know, it's funny. What we've decided in our family is that when I die,
yeah,
I if I have any money as an inheritance, which I'm hoping to have some, and I haven't spent it all, but assuming I have a small inheritance for my kids, the requirements for them to be able to get any of the inheritance money is that that I must be embalmed, and put in a glass casket, and put in their room.
Until what?
Forever. All time.
Awesome.
So and if they
remove you,
the moment I'm gone, then the inheritance goes with it.
That's strict.
So there it is.
That's good parenting.
That's some stuff Chris would.
Yeah, but then your great grandkids and everyone will like know you.
Yeah, that's exactly right.
Yeah, you'll be in everyone's life eternally.
That and then the other is of course to embalm or not to embalm to cremate. And then put it in an hourglass so you can be part of family game nights.
Oh, you just don't. You have FOMO already.
Oh, you know, I don't know.
I'm going to have an open casket and I'm going to require everyone to look in.
Yeah,
like there's going to be a strong guy that like walks everyone over.
He like
and
takes your head.
And everyone will see because I want. And I don't want to be embalmed.
You don't want to be embalmed?
No, you're just going to see who I am now at that time. I need a large guy, if anyone knows any, that'll do this with me.
All right. Next.
And next topic.
Next teaser. Yeah. Since all that talk, I feel like we should talk about the Horror Box a little bit.
Yeah, sure. I bet. I am a little spooked now, actually.
This is for the Gothic Box.
Plus.
Gothic Plus.
Yeah.
Horror Box, I just wanted to give someone said this was more of a spoiler than a teaser. Possibly. For the horror, this is a true teaser. Like what I wanted to say for this Horror Box that's coming up, it's the autograph for this is a really really interesting cool autograph. And I was looking it up today.
Yeah.
And the autographs start at between $55 and $60 on eBay for this person, and then go up from there. Like
I can see that.
This autograph for a $35 box is crazy. Mm-hmm. I can't really go too much more into it right now. We maybe save some more details on that for later. But guys, if you aren't getting the Horror Box this month, you really should, because it is
just sell it.
It's gonna be really cool. Yeah. It's totally worth it. So if you're into any of the franchises that you see on there, you'll definitely love
and
it.
And I don't even think this person signs like a whole bunch.
Yeah. Yeah. It's so it'll be interesting. Yeah. I think people are gonna love it when they see it, but yeah.
Oh yes.
Yeah. So that's my horror teaser, and I want to do one more teaser, and that is for our comic that we're offering right now. Now, as I said before, we're actually doing a giveaway of one of these.
Mm-hmm.
What I wanted to do, so the comic, it's a guaranteed 9.8 CGC comic by and the cover is by artist David Nakayama.
Mm-hmm.
And I got to meet David Nakayama. He's incredible. Really, really cool guy. I love him. He's a lot of fun. He's a fun guy. It's funny. Some people are like super serious, and some are people just like super laid back. He's one of the more laid back guys. But what I wanted to do is I wanted to show you guys as part of the teaser one of the other comics that David Nakayama has done. Just so you can kind of understand what the type of art it is. And this was actually for we did one of his covers earlier in the comic box, like back in like July, I think it was.
Oh, was it?
But we had it signed by the writer of the of the comic, not by Nakayama.
What's his name?
Jerry Duggan.
Yeah.
Who's also a really cool guy. But I wanted to show you. Cool, so this isn't CGC. This is CBCS because that's who we were using at the time.
Mm-hmm.
But what's cool about it, so this is David Nakayama's Color Bleed series, and what the Color Bleed is he takes a character and does just that character in super vivid colors with a straight color background, and it's just really cool. It's a really unique style, and it And what's cool about it is they're super collectible because mm-hmm. he does all the characters. Like various characters, and there's a lot of people that are working on you know trying to collect the whole mm-hmm. the whole set. This was a rogue that we did. So this is not the one that you guys will be getting.
No, but it is one of the giveaways for today.
But well, actually, no.
You said
no. We're giving away the actual comp.
Oh, com- we are.
Yeah, this is a CBCS. We're giving away a CGC.
That's 9.8. Even better.
So, yeah. Anyway, just that. So that's if you aren't familiar with David Nakayama or whatever, he's one of my favorite comic artists out there. Yeah, just yeah. because he has such a unique style.
It's really different.
It's
good art too. Like it's just good frameable right. art.
I have a Cyclops one at home.
Oh, do you?
It's not graded. I can't.
Yeah, but still.
I wish it was graded.
Yeah.
You don't want to know. It's too dang hard to get anything over a dang 9.4 these days.
Yeah, you're telling me. So, So that's just, if you guys are our comic box, if you haven't got that, it's live right now on the site. It's definitely worth getting.
Everyone was trying to get a hint. They're like, what color is it?
Can't tell you.
You'll immediately guess.
Yeah. So, some very cool stuff with that. So,
awesome.
Yeah. Let's talk through. Those are some stuff happening with BAM. Let's talk about stuff that's happening a little bit outside of the world of BAM. Because there's a lot of fun stuff. First of all, I went and saw a movie this last weekend.
Okay. Tell us.
I saw Everything Everywhere All at Once.
And what the heck?
So I didn't know anything about it.
Nobody
I don't know if you've seen it, say what you think of it in the comments. I don't want to necessarily give away too many spoilers in case you're still wanting to see it. But this is it. OK, so without knowing anything, I literally walked in having no idea what the movie was about.
Googly eyes.
Yeah.
Googly bagel.
It is trippy.
Is it really?
It's a movie where you're like. You're going, what in the world? Again, maybe if you go into it understanding that it's going to be that, then it's not.
But as much of a shock.
It's kind
of
like it's not like this movie, but I had the same experience with what was the movie that took place
Looper?
In
December
like
one?
Sweden? Yeah, Midsummer.
Oh yeah.
Midsummer was like when not knowing anything going into it, I was like, what in the world is happening?
Yeah.
It's kind of that same. It gets ridiculous at some points, but it kind of all comes around. And afterwards, like I went about halfway through, I'm like, what am I watching? But at the end of it, I'm like, oh, this was really interesting. And it's
the one thing I will say about it
is that it's in terms of plot, it deals with the multiverse. I know, which is interesting outside of like a comic setting.
Yeah, sure.
Because it's not like a comic based at all, but it's mm-hmm. Yeah. So
it's too confusing.
Is it like a spoof? Or no?
No.
Is it funny?
It's not a spoof. I would call it I wouldn't necessarily call it funny as much as it is like it's crazy. Meaning like they take it's absurd, maybe is the term I'm trying to look for. Is there's so many things that are just absurd in it, and then it all makes sense why at the end. Like
does it?
But it's absurd. Absurd, I think, is probably the best.
Sometimes that can annoy me. I'm like, that never made sense, and it never ended up making sense.
It made sense at the end.
Okay.
It made sense in the end. So, very interesting movie.
Wow, I want to watch it.
Speaking of movies that don't make sense or shows, if you guys have not seen Moon Knight. Really?
I guess I need...
It's good. Here's the deal with Moon Knight, in my opinion. Moon Knight, if you are familiar with the comics, it totally makes sense. If you're unfamiliar with the comics, it is everywhere at once.
Oh,
see what I did there?
Oh, wow.
Moon Knight is... It's really cool. I'm actually really liking it, but I'm having to do a lot of research to understand it, if that makes
sense.
Oh,
wow. So are you familiar
with
the
comics? Because I'm not. So I've had to go through, I have never read the comic, so now I'm having to go through and find out about all this stuff. It's awesome. It's really cool. I highly recommend it, but it's...
What I understand it? No.
I think you'd have, I mean, I, again, I think
like
you can kind of get a basic understanding of just by watching it.
I
but
think I would just enjoy it, though.
Yeah. I mean, it's a good story.
It still looks good.
I feel like the Moon Knight comics are confusing, though.
Oh, so it's supposed to be like that. You're dead on.
I don't
know. Yeah. Yeah. I mean, from what I've been able to, again, I haven't read them, but from what I've been able to gather from like synopses of them and such, they do seem pretty confusing.
Well, and I love Egyptian history and mythology and stuff. I think that'd be really interesting too.
And it's a take on like gods that obviously you know, we've kind of stayed in the MCU up with the Norse gods with like Thor and Loki and everything.
Whoa.
So now we're going to a different thing. So that's been kind of interesting.
Are the true gods? I'm so curious. I need to see a crossover. I haven't even seen the show yet, but I need to know if there's a crossover.
Speaking of, Mandy, do you want to show the Thor trailer that came out this week?
Yeah. I'm going to do it now. All
right, let's do it.
These hands were once used for battle. Now they're but humble tools for peace. I need to figure out exactly who I am. I want to choose my own path. Live in the moment. My superheroing days are over. Remember what I told you. You ever feel lost? Just look into the eyes of the people that you love. Not me. What? Just listening.
Wow. Jane Foster is the new Thor.
She's coming in.
It'll be interesting. I love that. I'm glad that Fat Thor is a thing of the past. I never loved Fat Thor.
Well, I would.
But yeah.
That's what I missed out on the most.
Is that Natalie Portman?
That's
why does it not look like her at all?
It looks like the chick who plays on You.
No, it's Natalie Portman, and apparently she's been like doing ridiculous workouts, getting ready for this thing. As you can, she's jacked in that,
arms.
Yeah, which is pretty freaking awesome. But
she's the best person probably ever, so I'm happy with that.
I love her.
Yeah, I think everyone does. Is there anyone who's like, I'm not into Natalie Portman?
They're wrong.
She's played some questionable roles, here we go.
Of course, it would be Chris.
Yeah,
I was like Chris.
Well, but what's one thing I am looking forward to that movie is so the villain is they didn't show it in the trailer, but yeah, Gore the God Butcher. So what's cool about that? So basically, Gore the God Butcher, he's a guy that first of all, it's played by Christian Bale.
Yeah, which why didn't they show it? Maybe they will next time.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Christian Bale. So Christian Bale, Dark Knight. Finally making it out to the MCU. Mm-hmm. It was like, when are they going to get Christian Bale in here? So that's awesome. Gore the God Butcher, he's basically this guy that grew up on this planet, felt like the gods, trusted the gods, felt like they didn't take care of him, bad things happened to him, and so he makes his life mission to kill and destroy every god in the universe,
and
of all types.
And I was looking at just imagery from the comics. He's like terrifying.
Yeah, I mean,
like, I don't want to see that.
When you decide to make it your life goal to destroy gods, it typically doesn't do wonders for your look.
Well, and too little calories or too something, too many calories. I don't know. He's kind of scary and spooky. He's like an alien. You said he's from a different planet.
Yeah.
Well.
So
never going there.
So he's apparently the going to be the villain in this. But so my question is, obviously they're just at the exact same time they're releasing Thor: God and Thunder, they're now having this Moon Knight series that's all about Egyptian gods, specifically in Moon Knight. To one.